Many people get offended if you point out how big a role chance plays in their success.
Very true.
And I get it. If we are just a product of our circumstances, then our hard work and our talent seem to count for nothing.
Agreed.
People think it has to be either skill or luck that explains success. But the truth is, you need both. Consider the most recent class of NASA astronauts. From over 18,300 applicants in 2017, only 11 were selected and went on to graduate from the astronaut training program. Now we can make a toy model of the selection process. Let's assume that astronauts are selected mostly based on skill, experience, and hard work, but also, say, 5% as a result of luck.
95 to 5.
For each applicant, I randomly generated a skill score out of 100, and I also randomly generated a luck score out of 100.
Oh, no.
Then I added those numbers together, weighted in the 95 to 5 ratio to get an overall score. This score represents the selector's judgments, meaning the top 11 by this metric would become astronauts.
There's your problem right there.
I repeated the simulation 1,000 times, representing 1,000 different astronaut selections. And what I found was the astronauts who were picked were very lucky. They had an average luck score of 94.7.
I highly doubt that.
So how many of the selected astronauts would have been in the top 11 based on skill alone? The answer was on average only 1.6. That means even with luck accounting for just 5% of the outcome, 9 or maybe 10 of the 11 applicants selected would have been different if luck played no role at all.
Okay. All right. Clearly this is wrong. We need to talk about this. My issue with Derek's video isn't necessarily with his conclusions, but rather the process he took to get there. In his thought experiment about NASA astronauts in training, he suggests that his assigned scores are pulled from a uniform distribution. That is, an astronaut has the same likelihood of getting an 80 in her score skill as 100. He doesn't explicitly say this, but in fact it's pretty much the only way to get the results he showed in the video. Generally, in the social sciences, if we don't know how an attribute is distributed over a population, we tend to assume what is known as a Gaussian distribution. In fact, these are so common in the world that they're really known as the normal distribution. There's theoretical reasons why this type of distribution is widely used, and if you want to learn more, I highly recommend you look up the central limit theorem. But intuitively, this makes sense, as according to the normal distribution, most people are somewhere near the middle, with smaller numbers above and below the average. There just aren't the same number of geniuses as there are of the normal scrubs like me. To investigate, I made a simple Python script to run the exact same experiment that Derek did in his video. I'm showing it in the background, but the code is available on my GitHub, which is linked below in the description. Very simply, I created a function that runs the experiment with 500,000 applicants with a selection rate of 10 to the negative 4. Then I calculated the average skill score of the selected cohort, as well as their average luck score. The weights for skill versus luck are exactly the same as in the reference video. Keep in mind, with the normal distribution, the average applicant has scores for both luck and skill centered at 50. There's also another script that runs a single experiment 1,000 times and then aggregates the results. The findings are clear. Using the normal distribution, the selected astronauts had an average skill score about 90, and their luck score was roughly 52, just slightly higher than the whole population average. In fact, calculating the same lucked out rate that Derek did over 1,000 experiments, only 7.5% of applicants got the job due to their luck. One interesting note, since both of our skill and luck distributions are normal distributions, then our lucked out rate from the experiment should also be a normal distribution, since it's a linear function of two normal distributions. And that's exactly what that histogram shows. So what does this all mean? I'm not suggesting that luck doesn't play a role in how the world operates. It surely does. However, the problem lies in using a flawed thought experiment to extract truth from it. In fact, I'm more than ready to admit that my own thought experiment is probably flawed, and the truth is surely much more complicated than what I've shown here. There's a temptation to point to these flawed experiments as vehicles to justify judgment. Oh, clearly these successful people are successful because they just lucked out. When the truth is, it's a lot more complicated than that. It's not just skill versus luck, but systemic injustices and oppression could also play a factor. Socioeconomic status could also play a role. And we don't know the weights for these factors. It might be that the weights we chose for luck versus skill are incorrect, and that luck should be weighted more heavily. However, at the end of the day, there's no need to be hyperbolic about the role that luck plays through flawed thought experiments, as that's simply not helpful in navigating our complex world. Luck is outside of our control. Skill is. And to an extent, even systemic oppression is within our collective control in terms of our willingness to fight against it. And that, I think, is really the takeaway from Derek's video, as he talks about a lot at the end. I just don't think it should be called a paradox. Thank you.